Hey, content creator, Regina here on The Daily, number 49. And my question for you today is, what changes could happen when you stay congruent in your content? And what does that mean? That means the message that you have giving out matches, or the message that you want to give out matches every piece of content that you have. So, I've given this example before. If you are putting someone through a sales funnel, for example, if the very first time, the very first touch point in an ad or whatever, that your audience sees you, is that congruent to when they put their name in your, or when they look at your sales page, to when they put their name in your opt-in form, to the first email that they get, to all the way till they purchase your product or service? Is that all congruent? Not even just that, even in all of your content. If you are a yoga teacher, for example, and all of a sudden you start selling essential oils or products without connecting it with your brand, that can get a bit confusing. If I'm expecting you to be a yoga teacher and I go to your website and I see things that don't match up, that's not really being congruent. So if you were to be congruent and keeping your message the same, how would it change your content? Just like I said the other day, I'm changing this up a bit, calling this The Daily, because they're not necessarily going to be tips. They're going to be questions that will help you think and help you figure out how you can make your content better. And I hope you guys have a great day. This is a beautiful little building here I saw on my walk, and I just wanted to do The Daily in front of it. Hope you guys have a great day. And I'll talk to you on The Daily, number 50. Cheers, guys. Bye.